Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This is part two of a tutorial showing how to create a gold medallion coin portrait with wraparound text. Picking up from where we left off, open your medallion coin folder and make the top layer active. Open the photo file that you worked on in part one. To place it into your medallion document, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the Medallion tab. Without releasing your cursor, drag it down onto the image and release. It's bright yellow because its layer is inside the Medallion coin folder, which is being affected by the color balance adjustment layer. Control-click or Command-click on the top layer mask to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Click the chain link button. In either the width or the height, type in 96%. Then click the check mark to accept it. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Click off the chain link to unlink the layer mask to the layer. Now we can resize and reposition the layer and the layer mask independently of the other. Click the layer to make it active. To resize and position it, open your transform tool. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, just drag it. Continue to finesse it so it's sized and centered on your medallion, making sure there's enough room for the wraparound text. Then press Enter or Return. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Close the Texture folder and open the Sketch folder. Click Base Relief. I'll make the light from the top left, the detail 14, and the smoothness 1. However, feel free to play with these amounts. Next, we'll draw the circular path that we'll place our text onto. Open your Ellipse tool and choose Path. If you're working on version CS5 or earlier, the Path tool is here. Click the gear icon, tick Circle, and check From Center. Go to the center of the guidelines and drag out a circular path a little past your subject. Then go to View and Clear Guides. To make it easier to see our text on the path, click off the eyeball next to your subject. Open your Horizontal Type tool and choose a font. I'm using a Parahita Regular. Its size is 18 points, smooth, and center alignment. Go to the top center of your path, and when you see this icon, click on the path and type out your text. To increase or decrease the space between the characters, drag your cursor over your text to highlight it, and go to Window and Character. The character panel will open. Slide the tracking icon to the left or right. Make sure you leave room for a new line of text at the bottom. Open your Move tool. To make your path visible again, open your Paths panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Paths. Click the Work Path thumbnail to see your work path again. Then open back your Layers panel. Open your Type tool again. Hover your cursor over the bottom of your path. And when you see the same icon, click on the path and type out your text. It'll be upside down, but we'll correct it. Open your Direct Selection tool and hover your cursor over your text. When you see this double arrow icon, drag your text up and over the path to make it right side up. To lower your text so it sits below the path, press T to open your Type tool and highlight your text. Drag the baseline shift icon to the left until the top of the text is flush with the path. If you want, you can also type in the amount. For this example, minus 10 sets the text perfectly. Open your Move tool. We'll place both layers of the text into a folder. Shift-click on the second layer to highlight it as well, and press Ctrl or Command G. Name it Text. Reduce the fill to 0. This makes the text invisible, but will keep its layer styles that we'll be adding to it visible. Make your subject visible again, and with your text folder still active, click the FX icon and click Bevel Emboss. Keep everything at their default settings, but make the technique Chisel Hard. Click Drop Shadow. Make the opacity between 60 to 65%, the distance 3 pixels, and the size 6 pixels. Then click OK. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.